Creating custom attributes or properties for devices allows you to use those attributes to assign devices to device groups or determine which policies or configurations get applied to which devices. Custom attributes could include things like location, warehouse ID, business unit, asset number, or whatever else you want to use to sort or identify devices. You'll use the custom attributes to determine things like which Wi-Fi connection the device should use, or which devices receive a specific OEM config app. You'll want to create the custom attributes in the Ivanti Neurons for MDM console before you import or provision the devices. Although you can assign the attributes to devices after they are added, it's much easier to assign them during the bulk enrollment process, so we recommend creating custom attributes first. To create global custom attributes, navigate to Admin, System, Attributes. Click Add. Provide a name for the attribute. And of course, we're creating a device attribute, so we're going to leave that option set to device. The usage field is not customizable, but it shows you how to refer to the attribute. Click Add to add the attribute to the system list. Once you've got the custom attributes created, let's talk about how you can use attributes to target specific devices. Device targeting is how you decide which devices get which settings. There are two ways you can target devices in Ivanti Neurons for MDM: device groups and user groups. We've already briefly mentioned using custom attributes to create device groups. Device groups are based on the device attributes, either the system-defined attributes or the custom attributes that you made. For example, you may want all the truck-mounted devices to receive software that you don't want on any other device. Use the custom property truck mount and then create a device group that only includes devices where truck mount equals yes. In addition to targeting device groups, you can also target a user or user group. For user targeting, each device is associated with a user account. You can use a single account for all the devices or associate different lists of devices with different email accounts. Each device is associated with exactly one account, though. To send configurations to the device, target the user that the device is associated with. Let's talk about a few ways you may structure things to make device targeting easier. In our first scenario, I have a limited number of devices, say less than 100. When I do a bulk enrollment, I use the same account for all the devices, and then I use device attributes to create device groups to do all the targeting. In this scenario, I don't even have user groups. If you've got more devices, the second scenario might work better for you. Here I have three different accounts, one for each of the three different locations I'm planning to manage. The devices at each location are associated with the account for that location when I create the device records. Then I can do user targeting for everything specific to location, and I use device groups for targeting specific types of hardware. A third scenario might be to use even more specific email addresses. For example, each email address could be for a location and a role. Create a user group for each location and a user group for each role. Then use device groups for specialized device targeting. The degree of complexity you choose depends on what you need to do, but shifting some of the targeting to users rather than doing it all in device groups is an option you should consider before you start importing devices. We've already talked about creating users, but let's walk through creating a device group. Navigate to Devices, Device Groups. Click Add. Provide a name for the group and a description if desired. Ivanti Neurons for MDM has two types of device groups, dynamic and manual. In a manual device group, an administrator adds devices one by one, and the devices are always in that group regardless of the device attributes. In a dynamic device group, devices are added based on the device attributes. If a device attribute changes, the groups that the device belongs to may also change. We're going to focus on dynamic device groups. In this first dropdown, select the attribute. It can be a system-defined attribute or one of the custom attributes that you created. Then decide what value of the attribute is going to define the group. This line is called a rule. If you want to use more than one rule to define a group, click the Add button to add another rule. When you have multiple rules, you can also decide if all of the rules must match for a device to be included, or if a device only needs to match one of the rules to be included. As you create the rules that define the group, the devices that currently match the rules are shown in the list at the bottom of the dialog box. When you're done, click Save. You can see on the device group page that the number of devices currently in the group are shown for each group. After you have device groups created, They automatically update based on the device's current attributes. You can use the device groups to target specific devices for software, policies, or specific configurations.